Alrighty, y'all. This is lesson four, and we are looking at Brook's Bouquet. This is the Epically Creative Weaving Course, Module 3A, Lesson 4, and I am Amy D. McKnight. In this lesson, you will learn what Brook's Bouquet is, how to weave Brook's Bouquet on an open shed, how to weave Brook's Bouquet on a closed shed, and some creative ideas for how to use Brook's Bouquet. What is Brook's Bouquet, or what Brook's Bouquet is? Brook's Bouquet, like lino, is a type of open weave. Sometimes we accidentally wrap our yarn around our warp threads. In Brook's Bouquet, we're doing this on purpose. You can weave Brook's Bouquet on an open or a closed shed. I'm going to be sharing both methods with you today. When woven on an open shed, you'll have warp floats on the back of your work. It's a good idea to weave a few picks of plain weave to keep those floats in check. When you weave on a closed shed, you'll catch all of the warp threads, so you will not have those warp threads floating along the back. Weaving Brook's Bouquet on a closed shed. Starting with your heddle in neutral, you want to wrap the yarn around the desired group of warp threads. Then you're going to pass the shuttle under the set number of threads and then out of the shed. You're going to circle back around to wrap the threads around the selected set of threads and catch the next set of warp threads. And we're going to keep doing that. When you get to the end, you're going to weave the next pick of plain weave and then beat. You're going to find an over my shoulder video of me weaving Brook's Bouquet on a closed shed, and it's going to be labeled Brook's Bouquet. I put both of them together, but you'll see. You'll see. Weaving Brook's Bouquet on an open shed. You're going to start on your dominant side. I'm a righty, so I'm going to start on my right. You're going to open a shed by putting your heddle in the up or the down position. If you can't tell by the picture, I am in the down position. You're going to put your shuttle into the shed and under however many threads you'd like to have in your little bundle. You're going to pass that shuttle up and out of the shed. And then you're going to circle back around to wrap the thread around those threads that you'd gone around to capture. And then you're going to go through your next set of warp threads. So you're kind of doing a loop-de-loop. When you get to the end, you're going to weave the next pick of plain weave and then beat. If it sounds familiar, it's because it's similar to the last. You'll find an over-the-shoulder video of me weaving. After this lesson, it is going to be labeled simply Brook's Bouquet. I'm doing both of the methods in that one video. Creatively weaving Brook's Bouquet. Again, like lino, it doesn't have to be woven evenly or balanced. You can use it to create an open space in the middle of the work if that suits your fancy. So, in this lesson, you learned what Brook's Bouquet is, how to weave Brook's Bouquet on an open shed, and how to weave Brook's Bouquet on a closed shed. And I gave you a couple ideas of how to use Brook's Bouquet creatively in your weaving. Take action now. I want you to weave along after or with the video as I demonstrate how to weave Brook's Bouquet. Why haven't you downloaded this already? I'm just asking. If you haven't already, why haven't you downloaded this already? If you downloaded it, leave me a comment in the video. Say, Amy, I downloaded the handout. If not, go download the handout. It's a great way to follow along with me as we go through all these skills. And I'm going to invite you, as always, to join my weaving community. We have monthly Q&As. We have ongoing projects, we have study groups, we have all sorts of really cool stuff happening in there, and there are an amazing group of people in there to share your creative journey with. Thank you so much for watching this. Please comment below and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Ring that notification bell and share this video. In the next lesson, you're going to learn what Spanish lace is, how to weave Spanish lace, and of course, some creative ideas for using Spanish lace. I will see you in that next video.